percents as proportions, and applications. Percent increase, decrease. When we have a percent increase or decrease, we have two types of scenarios. The one is where we are given our initial value and our final value, and we need to find the percent. So for that one, we would take the difference between our initial and our final. I think about those as being an absolute value because we want the difference between those and we want it to be positive. And it'll be over the initial amount. And then we would be finding the percent. So that would be our x over 100. In our other scenario, we're given the percent and we are finding either the initial or the final value. So our final value, if that's what we're given, goes on top. Our initial value would be on the denominator, and we would plug in a variable for whichever one we're missing. It will equal, we'll start with 100% minus the percent that they give us, all over 100. And so those are our two setups that we could possibly have. So let's take a look at our example one. In example one, we have the price of a sofa was $299, and during a weekend sale, the price was dropped to $179. What was the percent decrease? So this was the scenario where we have the initial and we have the final. So we're going to take the difference between those of $299 minus $179 over our initial value, which is $299. That will equal x over 100. 299 minus 179 will give me 120 over 299. And again, it equals x over 100. Multiply by our common denominators. I'll cross off 299 there, and I get 100 times 120, which will give me 12,000, equal to, our hundreds will cross off here, giving us 299x. Divide by 299, and I get that x equals 40.1337. Depending on where they ask you to round the decimal, depends on how far out you need to go. With this one, let's say we're going to go to two decimal places. So this would be 40.13%. Let's take a look at example two. In example two, we have that the population of a small town was 12,345 in 2000. And they say that this represents a decrease of 39.3% from 1990. What was the population in 1990? So that means that our population of the 12,345 in 2000 is the final amount. So that's going to go in our numerator. And we don't know what the initial amount is, so that's going to be x. So now for our percents, we have 100 minus our 39.3, and this will be over 100. We don't need to write our percents because they're not part of our calculation. So we get that 12,345 over x equals, we have 100 minus our 39.3, and that's going to give us 60.7. over 100. Multiply by our common denominator, and our x's will cross off here, and we get a really big number here, and our hundreds cross off here, giving me 60.7x. So we'll divide by 0.7, I should say. And I get that x equals 2,337.7. Now, because we're talking about this being a population and this being people, we don't normally have decimal amounts of people, so I want to round this whole person, and because this is a 7, we're going to round up. So this will be 20,338 for my population.